God gives us many, many things in life to enjoy. And he gives us talent and ability to enjoy the gifts that he has given us, so that football, center, how do you get ready for a game? You've got to practice. What happens if you don't practice for a game? Well, not only do you not do well, but your team doesn't do well. That not only applies to playing drums or playing football, it also applies to our faith. We have to practice our faith every day in order to become good Christians. And we need to have goals in our faith. And the ultimate goal in our faith is heaven. Who can tell me the name of one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit? I have one, knowledge, thank you very much. What's the gift of knowledge? It's the knowledge that we need to know that we are never alone. So often, we go on social media, people will talk about how alone they feel. They forget that Jesus is always with us. From the moment we get up to the moment we go to sleep, from the moment we're born to the moment we are born into eternal life, Jesus is always walking with us. And the saints, that the names that you've chosen this evening, those saints are walking with you. So knowledge is the ability to look through the dust and realize that God loves you so much that he'll never leave you alone. So that's an important gift, so that we don't feel alone and forgotten. Yes? Life is another important gift that God gives to us. And what he wants us to remember about life is that every human life is valuable, from conception to natural death. Even someone who may have a struggle through life, that no life is invaluable. Sometimes when people get older, get elderly, they're in a nursing home, some people begin to think, well, they're not important, we can leave them alone, and we'll shut them down. No. Every single life is valuable because everyone is created in God's image.
Good.
Yes. Understanding. Very, very good. And what's that understanding? It's understanding that God has a plan for us. That we're not just drifted in the universe. There's something that God wants us to do, and if we don't do it, it's not going to get done. So understanding is understanding God's will and then having the courage to do it. And that is the third gift of the Holy Spirit, courage. It takes courage to be a Christian. It takes courage to be concerned about the less fortunate. It takes courage to stand with someone who's being bullied and let that person know that you care about them. It takes courage to forgive. And that courage is yours in this sacrament. In a moment, you're going to come forward and I'm going to make the sign of the cross on your forehead. And I'm going to make it with oil. All through the Old Testament, when God wanted to designate someone as special, he anointed that person with oil. You're going to be anointed tonight because you're special to God. And that means that not only do you belong to Jesus, but Jesus belongs to you. And anytime you meet Jesus, you can call upon him, and through the Holy Spirit, he will give you the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, such as wisdom and understanding, right judgment, courage. All of those gifts are yours for your charge. All you have to do is ask for. So tonight, all these people are here, your parents, your brothers and sisters, your friends, Father Acker, as your pastor, and myself, and Monsignor Siffrin, all of us are here cheering for you. We're here for one reason, to ask the Holy Spirit to come upon you. To open the gift of the Holy Spirit. Open the gift of the Holy Spirit by opening your heart and letting the Holy Spirit come in, and then he will give you those seven gifts that you can use all through your life. And you'll never be alone, and you'll never have to be afraid. And there's nothing we need to fear when God is with us. And God is with you, and will always be with you, because he will never stop loving you. Open your hearts. Allow the Holy Spirit to come in and seize those gifts which are yours forever. God bless you.